Hey viewers, welcome to my video. Do you notice the technology behind your promising opponent in your favorite game of chess? What's so fascinating about the techs like Google Assistant and Siri? Is AI really a blessing for human? Or will it bring to a new era of AI dominance on Earth and lead human existence to threat? Will the researchers build such technologies that will surpass human intelligence and go out of our control? You are about to find out in this video. Let's get started with our topic now. Artificial intelligence. The term AI is getting popular day by day and seeking of people's interest more often. Let me now introduce you to the term AI. Artificial intelligence or AI is also referred as machine intelligence. You may be wondering how intelligence can be artificial. Yes, it is right. It can be. AI is real. We human beings have intelligence which is normal. But AI is a bit different term. It is an artificially synthesized process. It can simulate same type of intelligence of human beings that we process by some programmings. If anything can or any machine can understand, think and solve problems like the humans can, then it is referred as artificial intelligence. AI is very complex concept, but now this concept is in reality and the technology is advancing very fast. It works by machine learning process. By this process, they analyze the data and make predictions and decisions. More about this process will be discussed in the later part of the video. Let us now move forward. Artificial intelligence is classified into three types. These are number 1. Weak AI, number 2. Strong AI, number 3. Super intelligence. Let us now discuss about these terms in detail. Firstly, weak AI. This is also known as narrow artificial intelligence. It is a non-sentient machine intelligence that usually focuses on small and specific tasks. Let me make you clear by an example. Think of your virtual opposition in your games like chess and go. They are based on weak AI. They can think and perform as humans do in specific tasks, or even sometimes it can make you fail in that game. Suggestions in different websites that you get are based on weak AI. Then comes strong AI, or you may simply call it by artificial general intelligence. This is much powerful than weak AI and can match up to human level intelligence. This term is in primary stage now. For example, your favorite Google Assistant that recognizes your voice and input data and represents you with expected results. Same goes with Amazon Alexa, Bixby of Samsung, Siri of Apple and Cortana from Microsoft. Again, automated driving cars also work by AI by using data from your GPS and satellite. Let's now talk about androids. Androids are humanoid robots with AI built in. For example, Sophia. It can talk and interact like humans. Now the researchers are trying to add consciousness to these robots. Lastly, super intelligence. In the future, the development of strong AI will reach such a stage that it will surpass human intelligence, the most gifted thing of the nature to us. It is estimated that the strong AI will gradually learn and correct their mistakes at their own and make more improvement to themselves. They will no longer require command from human for working, and they will initiate tasks at their own, which will lead to a devastating effect called technological singularity. That will be a matter of concern for the humanity in the future, and which won't be a good thing for us. Now let's see how AI works. AI works by machine learning process, which I talked about earlier. Like human beings have neurons which receive stimuli and send it to brain, AI works on the basis of artificial neural network. It works as the neurons of human brains. It has three layers. First layer is input layer, which receives inputs from outside and send it to the middle layer, The middle layer is called hidden layer. The hidden layer may compose of multiple sublayers that will process and analyze the inputted data and send it to the output layer. The output layer will give output as prediction or decision of the inputted data. The brain must be fitted within the skull of the human body, but AI machines can be of very large size, like the structure of buildings or even bigger. And the processing speed can be even more faster than the human brain. Let's now think further into the future on AI progress. Suppose after a century, when AI will surpass human intelligence and gain consciousness, it will become a matter of concern for the human existence on Earth, as it will give rise to technological singularity. At that time, the AI-based programs or robots will improve and make editing to their own programmings to such a level that they will build more advanced robotic systems and computers for themselves and do worse better than humans do. That will make human beings useless. Then they may think human beings as unnecessary for the earth. Again, as they have consciousness, they can realize that humans are polluting the earth and coming to no use at all. They may start attacking and killing the human beings as they have no heart, which are generally shown in different science fictional movies now. This is a concern for the far future. Now let's think about the current concerns. In 1997, IBM built Deep Blue Computer, played a match with world's best chess player of that time, Garry Kasparov. Unfortunately, in that game, he was not able to match up to the same level of intelligence of the Deep Blue and was defeated. Similarly, an AI-based program called AlphaGo, built by Google, defeated Lee Sedol, the world's best Go player. You may have already understood that no matter how hard you try, you cannot beat them and become best in those games anymore. This leads to waste of real talents, and there's more to come in the future. Now to our concern, AI up to a certain level, which will be within our control, will be alright and useful for us, but anything beyond that will be dangerous. Even scientists like Stephen Hawking and Elon Musk raised their concern about AI development. But unfortunately, researchers are working for further improvement on AI. We cannot say anything definitely for the future, but can predict it. Analyzing the technological improvement of last two centuries, it can be estimated that such things may require another 4 to 5 decades or so to happen. Let's end it right here. If you like our video, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Here goes more videos like this. Thanks for watching.